Today's a local pizza review.
That's right, gotta keep it local.
A place I think we both have never had, right?
I have never in my life had this place.
This is the most reviewed pizza in this area of Chicago.
Second most
reviewed pizza place in all of Chicago. Today, come with us to Art of Pizza.
Yeah.
Decided to go a little outside of the normal realm, like this, to try a deep dish of stuffed pizza for the first time. A lot of people would probably do like the Chicago style or like pepperoni and sausage. We went a barbecue base, Southwestern. It's been acquired, jump cut. Ow. All right, Corey Wagner, second angle.
All right, first off, we're looking at a dope box. It's basically a painting on cardboard, I dig it.
Whoa.
Jesus Christ.
What in the holy hell is this? You can see the barbecue, you can see the herbs, you can see the crust, you can see it's thick. You can see the cheese, and you can see the toastiness. But does it taste good? That's what we're here to find out.
It's very true. So this thing takes 45 minutes to an hour to prep for you to pick it up. Is all that work worth the time? Is the flavor good?
For the consumer, probably. Because the consumer essentially does no work. They just get to do the picking up.
Sick. Attempt to grab one of these.
Good luck.
I don't even know what's gonna happen.
Good grab. Well grabbed.
Boom. Does it look like the pizza on my shirt? The answer is no. Art of Pizza Southwestern with the barbecue base. Cheers.
Cheers.
Barbecue sauce is nice and sweet.
That is a really good barbecue sauce.
So this was voted the number one deep dish pizza in Chicago by the Chicago Tribune. It's up there as well on Thrillist. Was it number one? It always is making pretty much any list, and we've never had it. Got that sausage layer in there on the bottom, how Chicago loves to do. But yeah, all the ingredients are kind of stuffed deep into the pizza. A lot of people at the restaurant will eat this with a fork and a knife. Found a way to do it with our hands.
This has got the classic problems I have with deep dish. Yeah, I'm just not caring for it, to be honest. Right out of gates.
What are the problems?
The taste is good, but it's so much freaking, like, look at, you can see on mine how thick the bread is, and you can see on yours, like, an eighth inch of that before you're getting to sausage.
Mm-hmm.
Easy eighth inch is just bread, like soggy bread. I don't know, it's just not for me. And I'm not getting a sausage layer.
Hey, your piece doesn't really have it.
No, because some places don't do that. Some deep dish places do, some deep dish places don't.
I know, I feel like I thought they did it.
I don't think they do it.
So this 10 inch pizza with 8 slices was $20 carry out, and it weighs 5 pounds.
So much.
It's the heaviest box of pizza you could ever have.
I feel like it's mostly bread though. I tell you what, the bark sauce is really good. I bet this on like one of their pan pizza. They have pan.
Yeah, thin crust.
Thin crust.
Pan.
I bet it's pretty good on there, but yeah, probably just don't like this style.
I like the cheese a lot.
It's good. There's no world where I'd want to buy this, but I'm just not a bread guy.
There's a lot of bread.
This is mostly bread.
I think it's fun to try it.
Labriola is way better, and Pequod's is way better. Both those places caramelize their crust.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, it's definitely not caramelized. No way.
Yeah, it's not as much of a butteriness and like a good salty. The end of the crust is kind of just like dull crust. You know what I mean? I'm not getting like, I'm not really excited to eat the crust of this pizza. Mm-hmm.
Not at all. It felt like a big waste of space.
Look at this thing. After two pieces are gone from it, you can see all the sauce kind of spilling out of it.
I do like their, like you said, good cheese, the sauce was great. I thought sauce flavoring was really good. And the sausage that I did have, I thought was good. I'd love to try it on a pan pizza, but then it was just that with like way more bread than I'd ever want.
Yeah, and this is also one of those things, like one piece is good.
If it was better, I'd eat more.
Put me in a food coma. You wanna do a Patreon shout out?
You better believe it.
Patreon shout out, Patreon shout out, Patreon shout out. Yeah, you looked at us, you know. One of those hooligans yelling in that car.
Our Patreon supporters are the nice, fine young ladies and gentlemen who support our channel every month by donating money. And they look at themselves in the mirror and they say, man, these guys are giving me 25 to 30 solid, amazing, great videos, great entertainment throughout the month. The least I could do is throw them a dollar.
Yeah.
A dollar for 25 to 30 videos?
Yeah.
You know, or more. So we appreciate that. We want to give them a little love on this channel. And that's what we're doing right here, right now. And we're starting that off with Orin Dix.
Great name.
Sounds made up, but I don't think it is. Dix isn't spelled the sexual way.
D-I-X?
D-I-X.
There we go. Patreon name number two, Mr. Steven Frizzone.
Ooh.
The Fry Zone.
Fry zone, get me in the fry zone.
Steve and Oren, thank you so much for donating. If you guys want your name shouted out in a video, patreon.com/number6withcheese. It's right here on screen because in editing, you can do that.
Woohoo!
All right, this highly hyped pizza, it's topping so many lists. It's time to rate our experience with it as far as the Southwestern style goes. Out of 5 Thanksgiving turkeys, how many Thanksgiving turkeys do you give the Southwestern stuffed 10-inch pizza from Art of Pizza Corey?
That was more or less garbage. That was just a whole lot of bread with a little bit of flavor. The sauce was great. Yeah, it tasted great, but bro, just a thick chunk of bread at the surrounding areas of that whole entire beast. I mean, we've had good deep dish. I also don't care for deep dish, but we've had deep dish that is digestible. This is not anything I'd ever want to get again. Other than having that sauce on a smaller thin crust pizza would be the only option I would go for. With that being said, I'm gonna give that a 1. Mm. A lowly, sad, single 1 for its rating. Sorry, Art of Pizza, didn't care for you.
So I can probably count on maybe 2 hands the amount of deep dish pizzas I've had. I've had Labriola. That's gonna just be straight up flavor. I've had Giordano's.
Mm.
I've had Lumalnati's.
I still bite into this and I'm like, oh, I've had way better pizza at way shittier places.
I've had Gino's East.
Really fresh.
I've had
Pequod's.
Pequod's.
Mmm. Oh boy.
I've had Pizzeria Uno.
Oh. That was a disgusting bite.
That is, I'm gonna go 2.0. I love Labriola. I think Pequod's is really good. Giordano's has come a long way for me. Lumalnati's I won't touch. Gino's East I won't touch. This I would give it another shot with different things on it. Maybe go just the pepperoni and sausage and try that. I wouldn't go out of my way to do it. If other people were like wanted deep dish and wanted to try Art of Pizza, that would push me to go. I'm not gonna order that for me and the girlfriend for dinner or something. So I'm gonna give it a 2.
No comment.
Thank you guys so much for watching yet again another video on Number 6 with Cheese. We'll be here tomorrow, Monday through Friday. We have a new upload every single weekday. So we hope you come back, check out all of our fun stuff on social media, our podcast, all those things are linked below. See you tomorrow.